All right, so I'm with Darnell Holloway from Yelp, and we are just wrapping up the session here. You were talking about Yelp and how businesses can get involved with it. How easy is it for someone to claim their own page?
Yeah, businesses can go to biz.yelp.ca to claim their free listing on Yelp. Also, if you're in the U.S., you can go to biz.yelp.com, same website. Every business can claim their free account and start using our suite of free tools. One of the primary tools is the ability to respond to reviewers, and you can respond either privately or publicly.
Is it true that sometimes you'll be on Yelp, and even if you haven't claimed a page, your business might actually have one full of reviews already or have some reviews already?
Mm-hmm.
So you don't need to have created one of these pages on Yelp for you to start potentially accumulating reviews from the public?
There's three ways that a business may end up on Yelp. One is the business owner may create a Yelp listing for themselves. The second way is that consumers can also create a Yelp listing. So if somebody's had an experience with a business and they want to start sharing those experiences, they can create a Yelp page where people can talk about it. And then we also pull data from Axiom, which is kind of a database of publicly listed businesses. So that's the basic kind of address and phone number information. So those are the three ways that a business may.
So it could be that they go to Yelp and they realize, oh my God, I'm reviewed and not even know about it.
That may happen.
Yeah.
We recommend that businesses, of course, claim their free listing and use the free tools on there. In addition to responding to reviews, people can also add content to their page. It's great to add photos, great to add information about the business to help consumers make a buying decision. And you can also track traffic. So we show you how many times your business is being viewed on Yelp. And we also show you stats on user engagement. So, for example, if you're a brick and mortar business, you can see how many people have checked into your business. You can also see how many Yelp deals you've sold, things of that nature, depending on the type of business.
And it's free to have a business page, but are there upgrades? Are there things? Can you pay Yelp a premium to get additional services for your business?
Yes, we make money via search advertising. So very similar to Google, if you want to get more traffic to your Yelp listing, you can buy search advertising. And there's also paid upgrades on the Yelp listing themselves, such as photo slideshow and video.
What happens if you get a negative review? Maybe you've signed up, you've claimed your business already. Yelp will email you an alert every time you get reviewed, and someone goes on there and slags your business. And maybe it's not even from a customer. How do you respond to that? What does the business owner do in that case?
Well, 80% of the reviews on Yelp are actually 3 stars or higher. So I think that's a really important thing to think about. One of the things that we talked about in the session here today is the fact that consumers and business owners look at Yelp listings a little bit differently. What we find is that business owners may know all of their negative reviews by heart, as example.
Right.
I see this time and time again. A lot of people know the date that it was posted, the exact word-for-word quote from the review, and then the name of the reviewer. Consumers are looking at Yelp listings a little bit differently, though. Consumers are looking at overall trends. They want to see what the majority of people are saying about a particular business when they're making their buying decision. I think a good way to think about this is that negative stimuli is usually more impactful when it's about you personally than when it's about a third party.
Right.
So that's the first thing that we want people to keep in mind.
So people, when they go to Yelp, they're taking a look at all of the stuff as a whole. And this is the way I've done it as well. I don't use Better Business Bureau or the Yellow Pages anymore. I go to Yelp. I found my carpet cleaner that way. I typed in carpet cleaner, and I found the ones with the highest reviews. I took a look. And, in fact, the one that I ended up going with had a couple negative reviews, but he had 20 that were fantastic. So as a consumer, in my head, I just kind of wrote those people off as idiots in a way. But what happens if you are a business and you do actually get something, and you know for whatever reason, in fact, I've seen this with realtors every once in a while, someone will post a negative review about a realtor online, and the realtor will be in there saying, wait a minute, we never sold anything to this guy. Is there a mechanism for pulling that negative review, or at least alerting Yelp to it that it might be fraudulent?
Well, I think the bigger question is, what does Yelp do to protect both business owners and consumers from reviews that are questionable? And so I think if you were in the session, I'm not sure if you caught it, but we talked a little bit about the review guidelines as well as the review filter. So I'll kind of walk you through those. I think it's important, though, to touch on the fact that we don't arbitrate factual disputes, right?
Mm-hmm.
So rather than kind of be a moderator between a consumer and a business owner, we give businesses the ability to respond directly to their reviewers as part of our suite of free tools. So that's something that we recommend that everyone does. However, if something gets posted to the site that is in violation of our review guidelines, for example, then things like that will be taken off the site if they're brought to the attention of the user support team. And so there's three things that they look at primarily. First thing is that we don't allow hate speech, threats, or harassment in the content of reviews. It makes sense. We also want reviews to be a first-hand experience, so no writing reviews about something that your friend told you about a business.
Oh, okay.
And then also, if there is a conflict of interest, so, you know, if we can see on its face that a review represents a conflict of interest, I'll give you an example. I've seen cases where, auto mechanic A may go over to auto mechanic B's Yelp listing and say, you know, screw this guy, come to my shop.
Right.
You know, kind of thing. If we can see that on its face, then things like that will also get taken down if brought to the attention of the user support team. To bring something to the user support team's attention, people can go to yelp.com.ca/contact or yelp.ca/contact or yelp.com/contact. There's a drop-down menu. Questionable content is one of the options. The other mechanism of quality control that we have in place is Yelp's review filter. And so very early on, we understood there's a certain behavior pattern that exists on the internet in general, which is that there are people that may come to review sites to create fake profiles to spam themselves or spam competitors. There's even people out there that are paying people to write fake reviews for businesses online. So because that kind of activity exists on the internet in general, we wanted to take an aggressive approach against things like that that may get posted to the site. And so that's where the review filter comes into play. What the review filter is an algorithm that looks at a set of data points about everyone that's posting reviews on Yelp. And it applies the same logic across the board equally to all users and all reviews on Yelp, no exceptions. And it's basically the most effective way for us to address the issue of shill and malicious reviews that may get posted to the site.
Right. What's the biggest mistake that businesses make on Yelp?
I would say my advice to any business owner is to not overreact if you do get a negative review. The reason being is that any business that's open to the public is probably going to get a negative review at some point. It's human nature. It's impossible to please 100% of the people that you deal with 100% of the time. And for that reason, if you do get a negative review, don't overreact. Take a step back. And also, if it makes sense, you may want to delegate someone else to be kind of the review response person at the business. And you always want to approach it very diplomatically, address whatever people's concerns are, and then move on from it. And really, businesses that take that approach are the people that we consistently see having the most success overall.
biz.yelp.ca to register. It's free to register your business, and you get all sorts of great tools. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you.